Moshi Moshi, everyone.
Welcome to the season 2 of Moshi Moshi Talks. In this season, we'll be talking about remarketing. My friend, remarketing is a very different tool that the digital marketing industry has found out till now. Okay, the industry is growing at a 30% rate, the digital marketing industry. And there are more than 500 million website users or internet users. And if you understand, this rate is increasing as we are talking. So remarketing plays a very wide role because the number of users are increasing so fast that we can do wonders with remarketing. Remarketing is nothing but retargeting your customers who are going digital. Okay? So there are two ways of doing remarketing. First way, anyone who is visiting your website, you are retargeting them. So let's take an example. If someone is visiting Moshi Moshi's website, what we generally do, we drop a cookie in their browser. So as soon as they go to any place, so there are two, three ways of doing it. So let's say someone who is going to any of the Google display network. So simply making you understand. So let's say when you go to money control or you go to any of these websites and read content, there are small display ads that comes, right? And these are very retargeted ads. You must be wondering, okay, today I was just seeing this mobile phone in Amazon, and why is this Amazon following me everywhere? This is what they are doing. You have visited Amazon's website, and now Amazon is making sure wherever you are going, you are getting the target ads, right? It can be done in Google Display Network, it can be done in YouTube. So whenever you are going to YouTube, you see a skip and non-skip ad. Whoever is your website visitor, you show them the ad, and accordingly, you show them the content. So this is the way remarketing is done when someone is visiting your website. There's another way of doing remarketing, and this is the most interesting way, and I really like this side of it. What happens in remarketing here is, this is happening remarketing via competitor. So anyone, let's say Moshi Moshi competitor, there is XYZ advertising agency. I want to tap in the customers who are going to that XYZ advertising agency. So as soon as someone visits that website, what I do, I ask Google, I want targeting to happen of all these customers. So whenever someone is visiting, let's say XYZ advertising agency, we start showing our display ads there. We start showing our YouTube ads there. So yahan pe kya ho raha hai? It's a very cool thing. Let's understand this. Let's say I'm very new in the market. Moshi Moshi is just 1 year old. And I know there is XYZ advertising agency who is running this industry for past 15 years. And I know I have a better product, by the way. We have a better product, you know that. Okay, so let's understand, we have a better product. What we are going to do is, we will start showing display ads to them. Display ads will be nothing in the form of GIFs or whatever we want to. And then we can start showing ads to them. What is happening here is, we are catering to the similar audience, which is impossible in any other form. Understand this part. Can you do this on offline? You know you are Max Retail and you want to really target people who are going to Van Heusen or let's say Pantaloons. You can't really do that, right? You can't really tell whoever is going to Pantaloons, I want to target them. You can't really do that. What will happen here is, I'll tell you. Abhi, let's say anyone, let's talk about online now. There is Flipkart bhaiya and there is Amazon bhaiya, right? What we are going to do, anyone who's visiting Flipkart, Amazon wants to retarget them. What they will do, as soon as someone visited Flipkart, I can show them the ad. Flipkart will start showing ads. So let's say I've visited Flipkart and I've seen, let's say, a sexy Mi phone. What Amazon will do, okay, Flipkart is selling it for 7,000 bucks. I'm going to do a display ad targeting, I have a phone, same phone available for 6,500 bucks. What happens here is, I'm able to re-tap the same customer. You wonder this, right? Whenever you go and check a product in XYZ website, you start seeing ads of the same similar categories. It's a very smart thing to do. So remarketing on the whole is super smart. So let's talk about cult as a possibility. So let's say whoever is visiting cult is a health conscious crowd, right? So you can create your audience on the basis of that. Cult is health conscious. What do you do now? I am launching a new organic cream. I know this health conscious crowd is gonna dig that. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna create a remarketing ad. And what I can do here is, I will tell whoever is visiting cult, I want you to show my ad to them. What is happening here is, this is a super cool thing. You can create any audience out of it. Let's say Oyo. Whoever is visiting Oyo is traveling for sure. So any traveling company, let's say Zoomcar, wants to show the ad to them. Or let's say any particular segment, Zoomcar, party places, events high, they can show nearby events happening when you're visiting these areas. So you are able to cater an audience accordingly. And this is the best thing to happen, I think, to the industry on the digital front, because when there are 500 million users, it's not the niche industry anymore. It's like the mainstream media now. So you can't really retarget show ad to everyone. Let's retarget it to people who are very specific to your audience, who are actually searching for this particular thing, or who are actually your direct audience. Let's say whoever is, I'll give you another example. Let's say I'm starting with a brand which is similar to Lenskart. I will not have so much patience. Generally in offline, what I'm going to do, I will have to increase my budget and do marketing to random people, as many people as possible. Yahan pe I'm going to do very different thing. One small thing. I know my products are cheaper than Lenskart and I have a value which is similar to Lenskart on the product offering end. What I'm going to do is I'll do a basic display ad of as many people who are visiting to Lenskart, show my ad, show my products and give them a one lens free or one specs free or whatever campaign that I want to run. But what I'm doing here is this is a very smart thing. I'm showing it to people who are visiting Lenskart. This is a very cool thing. You can think of any industry. Cult, I'm starting with Gold's Gym. I can tap in people who are visiting Cult. Let's say I'm talking about jewelry industry. I can tap in people from jewelry industry. People talk about jewelry when it's occasion. A card company can retarget them. Anything you can think of, any industry, you can actually create your audiences on the basis of that and then remarket them on various ages. So remarketing actually works out really well. I'm going to give you 2-3 reasons on that. So remarketing is fairly a very new concept. So people think you're a very innovative company. Not a lot of people know about remarketing, right? So let's say you visit Moshi Moshi's website and when you go to the YouTube page or when you're watching, let's say, Prem Ratan Dhan Payo, and then you're seeing the ad, you'll be like, I don't know how it is being shown to me. So you start thinking about the brand on a different level. Remarketing works out really well there. It's actually really smarter than normal DM. What actually is happening here is, in digital marketing, as I mentioned earlier, there are 500 million active online users or digital users or internet users. What is happening here is the industry is still becoming more cluttered. A normal DMA, what was happening? We were showing ads to people who were specifically searching for this. But what is happening here is in remarketing, you're showing ads to people who are even going to your competitor's website. So let's say you have a client, right? You are Max Fashion. You are showing at least ads to people who are searching for clothing, which is the first target group that you have. This is basically whoever is searching for a shirt, that's your TG. So you're showing ads to them. That makes sense completely. But you are missing on an audience, right? You're missing on Pantaloons, whoever is visiting Pantaloons or Van Heusen for that matter, or Bangalore Central for that matter. What you can do is you can start showing ads to them. So it's actually smarter than normal DM because you are able to retarget the same audience. Whoever is going to Pantaloons or let's say Van Heusen for that matter, and this makes a lot of sense. Normal DM is actually the best thing to happen in the world, I would say, in marketing, because you're actually able to tap in people who are searching for products. But yahan pe you're actually able to retap your competitors, which is a bliss in the current scenario. You know that there's a 70% increase in conversion when remarketing happens, and 3 out of 5 website visitors really like when they are retargeted and they reconsider the product. So let's say there are 10 clicks out of every 1,000 impressions which are happening in normal ads. There is an increase of 10x. So there are 100 clicks which are happening on remarketing ads compared to every 1,000 impressions which are happening. So there's a 10x pump. It really increases your conversion because you are able to tap in the audience who are directly your audience. They are exactly your audience, maybe buying from somewhere else, maybe buying from a Cult, or maybe buying from a Gold's Gym. But they are direct your audience. You are running a gym, they are directly your audience. So let's tap in. Remarketing can really change and do wonders for your business. That's all on the first episode of the season 2. It's a wrap. It's a wrap.
Just give it
my idea. It's a wrap. It's a wrap. It's a wrap.